I upload on Wednesdays and Saturdays. I will see you all again on Saturday.
24 hours later.
Hey besties, it's Nat, back again with another Animal Crossing speed build, and today we're continuing to work on my New England themed island of Nautilus by building the Main Street area. Now, as you can see, I've already decorated Main Street a little bit. I did back in, oh my god, November of last year when I worked on the little forest area in between this area and the beach, but here it is right now. It's cute, but it's a little bland, a little boring, and the buildings are a little too close to the street. So we're gonna set them back. We're gonna add a little more, a little extra, zhuzh it up a little bit. Hopefully really channel those town core vibes for this one. So grab a snack, grab something to drink, and let's get right into it. Hey besties, it's voiceover Nat, and I can imagine that after the beginning of this video, you have a couple of questions, especially because the intro was so normal, but the very beginning of the video was not normal. So I'm gonna get some housekeeping things out of the way as we begin the build. We're gonna visit a campsite villager. Spoiler alert, it was Hopper. He was very cute. I took a picture of him. Newt. Penguin gang. Anyways, you're probably wondering what was going on in the intro of this video and also why this video is coming out on a Sunday, and I can answer both those questions with a quick story time while we say hello to Hopper and download a new road code. And by new road code, I mean an old road code, because I switched back to Colin Crossing's road code because I needed more design slots. And the Arrigo Alley code was taking up too much space in my design slot, so hence we switched. I briefly switched to the light-colored road code. I really liked it, but at the same time, it was really, really bright, and I felt like I needed a little more contrast on my island. But let me know if you guys think that it looks good, because I kind of want to switch back to it. I don't know. I'm having a bit of a crisis right now with my codes. Same with this brick code that you see running up and down. I kind of have a different code that I want to use for that, but I'm like, I really like my bricks, so maybe I'll change the color of them. I don't know. I'm having a code crisis, but we'll get into that later. Right now, it's story time, because I had an interesting week. So earlier this week, my Wednesday video ended up going up on a Thursday because of the bug incident, which if you saw my last video, you will have heard about. By the way, you should check out my last video. Normally I don't plug a video like immediately after I post it, but that video, I'm very proud of. I think that beach turned out really great, and I keep hanging out there and forcing my sibling to hang out with me at the beach. So yeah, check that video out. Anyways, so yeah, after I posted that, I was like, okay, I'm gonna post on Saturday, I'm gonna be normal, I'm gonna do my Wednesday-Saturday upload schedule, even if the bug doesn't want me to do that. So, you know, I was going about my business as usual. I took a little trip down to the grocery store to buy myself lunch. This was Friday, by the way, so a day before I'm supposed to upload. Around, like, 2 or 3 o'clock, you know, a normal, like, a little late lunch. And I almost passed out, right outside of the store. Luckily I got to the store, people in the store helped me, and they called the ambulance, and the ambulance came and got me. Now, okay, this seems really dramatic. It was a little bit dramatic, but not really, because, for those of you who don't know, I don't know if I have a condition or something. I have never been diagnosed with anything, including in this trip to the hospital, but I have this thing where, like, once or twice a year, every year, like, as, like, a little annual treat, like a present, my body just becomes completely dehydrated and I just pass out randomly. Like, it just happens. And today, I guess, that day was the day. Not today, I mean the day that it happened, but you know what I mean. Anyways, that was the day, and I wasn't expecting it to be the day, but it was, and that is why the video is a day late. But you know, that's neither here nor there. You guys want to hear about the actual trip itself. So the first hilarious thing that happened was, oh yeah, I'm moved the store, and now I'm putting a wooden board fence behind it. Anyways, the first hilarious thing that happened is I got catcalled as I was being wheeled into the ambulance on the stretcher. The two EMTs were putting me on the stretcher outside the store, and this guy was pulling in to get his groceries, and he had to, like, slow down so he could back up into the parking spot. But he had his window open, and he, like, stopped for a second and then did a double take. And as they were wheeling me into the ambulance, he was like, "God damn." And I'm like, "Sir, I am on a stretcher. What are we doing?" So yeah, that was the first hilarious thing that happened. The EMTs thought that was hysterical. And I mean, they're right. That is hysterical. Like, what, who does that happen to? Who does it happen to? Too many things happen to me. People, I don't know. I feel bad when I'm like, "Oh, the video's gonna be late," or "Oh, my schedule's off because something happened to me." But too many things happen to me. Why do things keep happening to me? Anyways, so that happened, and then we get to the hospital, and things are mostly normal. I had an incredibly nice nurse. She looked and sounded like Molly Shannon, doing like a southern accent, like the most southern lady that you could imagine. I loved her. And I spent a good maybe like 6 hours in the hospital. I got 2 IV bags to juice me back up, and that was pretty much it, to be honest. I watched Pokemon while I was in the hospital, waiting for my test results to come back, and nothing about them was weird, so they sent me home. I've been resting up. I've been ordering a lot of Uber Eats so I don't have to walk anywhere. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Story time over. I hope you enjoyed that. I wouldn't say that I enjoyed it personally, but looking back, it is pretty hilarious, all of the events that occurred. And hopefully next time I post a video late, it won't come with a story like that. Anyways, oh wait, this is a really cute conversation between Pecan and Butch. Pecan and Butch have a little something going on. Actually, okay, I always say this, but I am working on The Sims off camera, setting up all of the Sims and their relationships and building them houses and things. And I'm working on Pecan and Butch right now, and they're having a little back and forth in that game as well. But I just thought that this conversation was really, really cute. I love old people. And I miss putting conversations in speed builds, so you're getting one right now. I know this video is kind of long, it's on the longer side, but I just thought, you know, a little levity after that story would be nice. And you know, it was really adorable. But yeah, I am doing a build today. We are building. It's not just a story time. As I said at the beginning, this is my town square area. I am doing a New England town core themed island based off of the island that I grew up on. Last video, like I said, we did the beach, and that was really, really fun. And this video, we are doing a little refresh of my main street area. So I moved the Able Sisters, and now I'm working on the path again. I decided to switch the path underneath the custom design from the stone path to the dirt, just so I could extend the dirt if I wanted to and have it be like, I don't know, like a separate path. I don't know how to describe it, but like I said earlier in the video, I am having a bit of a crisis with my codes where I have trouble letting go of codes. I'm like, what if I get rid of the code and then I change it for something else, and then I realize afterwards that I liked it better the old way, and then I have to re-download everything and then place it down the way that I did it before because I really liked the way it was before. But I just need to get over that. You know, I need to get over my attachment to codes. If I know that they still exist and they haven't been deleted, then they're just going to be there and I don't have to worry about it. But yeah, I definitely have a bit of attachment issues with codes. I switched to Collins Road code, like I said, because I needed more space. The Arrigo Alley code has separate codes for the diagonals, and I have a couple of spots on my island that use diagonals. This is one of them. The other one is by my lighthouse. There's a long diagonal stretch of road there, and this one I can just place down the regular corner tiles and have them be a diagonal, so that is why I switched it. Like I said, I'm kind of torn between this one and the light road path, but we'll see which one I end up with. By the way, every time you see like a rare butterfly in this video, I did catch it. I am a bug catching fiend. I cannot stop. Same with fishing. If I see a big fish, I have to go for it. If I see a rare butterfly, every time you see an Agrius butterfly fly by in this video, 1,000 miles an hour, I chased after it and caught it. This video, 99% of this video, the editing was just me cutting out, running back and forth to my storage, going to Harv's Island, and catching butterflies, and occasionally popping balloons. Because once again, I've said this in my videos before, every time you see a balloon, I pop it. It's just a compulsion. I have to do it. But yeah, this build took me a while. It took me a long time. That is why this video is the length that it is. I tried speeding it up. Oh, there's another butterfly. I tried speeding it up to 550%, but I think that was like a little too fast, so this is at 500%. Let me know how the speed is. Also, apologies that my microphone is being a big weirdo. I'm still adjusting the sound from when I moved because I don't know what my new setting should be, because my old settings were so extreme because of all of the background noise that I was trying to filter out. And now I'm trying to filter out is like the wind and like the AC unit and everything. So I'm still working on it, besties. Apologies for that. But I hope you can enjoy the lovely background music, at the very least, if my voice does not sound the best all the time. But yeah, I'm putting back Able Sisters. I left the beach outside of my house open so that I could put buildings down when I moved them. And so that'll probably be the last beach that I decorate, just because I need that space to put buildings if I move them. I also, honestly, after finishing this build, I kind of wonder if I need to move the shops back one more space, just because I ended up using a lot of space on the road to place objects, and it looks cute. I think it would be, it's a cute concept that this area is like closed off just for pedestrians, even though it does have a crosswalk. That doesn't really make sense, but like, you know, just let's be a little imaginative, you know, maybe it has the crosswalk, but it recently closed down and is just for pedestrians. But yeah, there's a lot of like little stands set up of like displays for the different shops. So I might end up moving Able Sisters and maybe even Nook's shop back one more space, but I don't know yet. I am not super attached to having my river be super wide, so we'll see. And also I'm not super attached to the bridge that I end up putting down. Not that I don't want the bridge, I do want the bridge, it's just that I'll delete the bridge and then build it again if it means that I have more space to do what I need to do. But yeah, it's starting to come together, the shape and everything. I put this little clothes drying rack. I had this before and I wanted to keep it. I thought it was really cute outside of Able Sisters, as well as putting some wheat fields behind the store. My island, I'm not going to say it's laggy. It's a little bit laggy, but it's not like debilitatingly laggy, if that makes sense. I don't know how else to describe it. I'm really, there's a build, like I said, that I'm working on, I've said this in previous videos, that involves a lot of wheat fields, and I think that once that build is done, and I have all of them down, then we're gonna see the real extent of the lag that's going on my island. But for now, it's certainly bearable. There are a couple areas where, you know, things pop in and out. Later in this video, I ended up using the rescue service because I got stuck really quickly, and they dropped me at resident services, and everything popped in it all at once. But it's not the worst. Building this was pretty easy. I had a little bit of trouble when I was playing like off camera for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe it's just like handheld mode or something. But it's fine. Everything's fine. If my island ends up being laggy, that's just because of my too much gene. For those of you who don't know, I am an Aquarius sun, and I am a Virgo moon and rising. So the too much gene is within me, besties. And you're gonna see that in this build. One thing about this build, okay, first of all, one thing about me, I keep telling you things about me. I'm like, for those of you who don't know about me, but it's my video, so I can say what I want. Anyways, for those of you who don't know about me is no build on my island is ever truly done, okay? I adjust things, I fidget with things constantly. I'm actually gonna go back and work on a bunch of things that I've already worked on, and I'm gonna make videos of that process. But nothing is ever complete on my island, really truly. So little things will change here and there. For this build, this is one of those builds where I'm like, I just have to stop touching things. I have to stop touching things. I have to get the build done. I have to get the build out because I kept fidgeting with things. I might adjust some of the objects because there is a lot of stuff in this area. Like I said, if there was a car trying to go through here, it would have a tough time. There's a lot of stuff out on the street. There's a lot of leaf piles. There's a lot of like bags and drinks and stuff lying around. It's cute. It's really, really cute, but it's a lot. So I might pull back a little bit, be a little bit more of a minimalist. If I am capable of doing that, we'll see. I don't know if I'm capable of that, but that's for, you to find out and me to find out together, as a team, as you and I together. What am I even saying anymore? I cleaned up that area. I don't know when I'm gonna adjust that, but this whole area, I scooted it back a little bit. We're gonna make the river a little bit narrower. Like I said, I don't mind having my river be narrow. So we're gonna move it back a little bit, and we're gonna add some more stuff behind the store. We're gonna add a truck for the produce. There's a lot of cute little store objects. Also, I finally bought the ABD machine for 9,000 Nook Miles points. It really hurt. It did. It really did. But I got it over with. It was over and done. There, I caught another butterfly. And I got to use it in this build, which is really exciting. I feel like I should have mentioned that earlier, but I was too busy telling my hospital story. Oh yeah, and by the way, I also hid a cicada behind Able Sisters for the ambiance. You know, you gotta hide your bugs, besties. You gotta utilize everything that is available to you in the game. Every object, every one of those cute little things you can hold in your hand, put them on the ground, a bug, a sea creature, anything that you can find, use it in a build. I don't know. That's my best advice for this game is if the game gives it to you, put it in a build. Try using it. Ooh, speaking of putting things in a build, I also downloaded this adorable plastic bag code. I think that I saw it in a list the last video. I'm trying to remember. I watched a ton of Animal Crossing YouTube while I was recovering after my incident the other day. Normally, I get stressed watching other people do builds because it reminds me that I need to do a build. So I'm like, oh no, I this is just reminding me that I need to get work done. But you know, in this case, I was like, oh, you know, this is nice. I get a chance to just chill and enjoy what other people are up to. So yeah, that's my other piece of advice is get inspo from the community. There's so many talented people. That's how I got the inspo to do my beach build, is that someone else on Instagram posted a picture of the wooden storage shed as like a little changing room on the beach. And I was like, oh, that's perfect. And now I have a wonderful beach build that I love. So yeah, those are my two pieces of advice. Get inspo and use bugs everywhere. Put bugs everywhere. That's my two pieces of building advice. Wow, what a great video. But yeah, like I said earlier, having a bit of a code crisis, but now that I have more space, I can download adorable codes like that to add to my builds and add a little bit of pizzazz. But yeah, moving this back a little bit, I wanted the fences to be somewhat aligned, but they ended up being a little bit like offset from each other. So I might adjust that a little bit. It depends on what happens behind this build, because as you can see behind this build, we have Fuchsia's house, a bit of a sleigh that was, not gonna lie, Fuchsia's house. I think it turned out pretty good. But Fuchsia's house is a florist, and then Butch owns a junkyard slash farm, and a pecan. I don't know what pecan's gonna be. I don't know if I want her to have an antique store or maybe something else. I don't know if I want her to be a girl boss. Everyone on my island is a girl boss, and it's a bit of a problem. But we'll see what pecan ends up having. Maybe we'll do like a little bit of a yard sale. Oh, here are the girls. I tried to get a better picture of them together, but Coco moved because of course she did. But yes, as I was saying, I kind of want to move the yard sale that's in front of my town hall and adjust my town hall area a little bit and make my entrance a little bit different. So maybe I'll find a spot to put the yard sale behind this, because I kind of want this entire area to be like downtown, if that makes sense. Like, this is the main street where the two main shops, and then you cross the bridge and then there's the flower shop and then Butch's house, and then you cross another bridge and then there's the ice cream stand and the playground and the gas station that Bob owns. And so it's all sort of centralized. And then on the other side with the beach, there is the seafood restaurant and the museum and the pottery studio and all of that stuff. So that's sort of the plan as of right now. So this behind this area is going to be more sort of downtown feeling spots. We're really channeling town core besties. We're really getting into it, digging into it. Honestly, looking at this back, I kind of miss having the bricks over on the left side of Nook's Cranny, just because I feel like it like really ties it in. So I might go back and put the bricks back. I don't know. I ended up moving everything, all the trees in this area, because I wanted to make a little area to put the shopping carts. I really love the shopping cart object that came with the 2.0 update, and I wanted a place to store the shopping carts. And I thought, oh, this area next to Nook's Cranny in between the store and town hall is perfect. So I just adjusted this. I used this fence that I use elsewhere on my island. It's just like a little barrier for the carts to keep them in. And I think it turned out really cute, but I ended up replacing the bricks with the sidewalk code, and I think that it looks good, but I kind of wish that I had kept the bricks. I don't know. Like I said, I'm torn about the bricks. I like how they look, but also I kind of want to try something else. So I don't know. We'll see. Like I said, nothing on my island is ever done. My overarching plan for Nautilus is that I want it to be the island that I sort of play the game on and sort of update seasonally. So my timeline is that I want to have a finished dream address version of Nautilus that you can all visit by the end of this year, so that I can upload it and you can all come and take pictures and visit and meet my villagers and see all their lovely houses. And then after that, I want to just slowly change things like a little bit at a time, and then mostly just use this island for gameplay, finally finish my museum and all of that stuff. So that's the plan for Nautilus, and then hopefully by the end of the year I will have saved up enough that I can get a second Switch, and then I can use that Switch to do crazier, more out there themes and islands and sort of update it, reset it more often and change it up more often, if that makes sense. That's sort of my plan going forward. But for now, we're stuck with Nautilus. You're stuck here, you're trapped here, you cannot leave. But I hope you enjoy it, because I do. I love my villagers. I wouldn't trade them for the world. Every time I get a campsite villager, it's like, you're cute, but I can't take you because my villagers have my heart. Honestly, speaking of things that have my heart, looking at some of the more, let's say, minimalist design choices that I did earlier in the build, I'm like, why didn't I keep that? You know, the too much sheen, why didn't I keep that? I could have just not done as much as I did. I could have stopped earlier. This video did not have to be 40 minutes long, and yet it is. So, you know, here we are together. You and I, once again, like I said. I'm adjusting things back there. It ended up not being... what's the word? Oh yeah, that's when I used the rescue service. I must have cut out the part where it lagged when I got back to when I got back to Town Square. I cut out a lot. Like I said earlier in the video, I cut out a lot of stuff, and it was mostly me running back and forth to my storage or running back and forth to Harv's Island because I kept changing the colors of things. What is one of the biggest challenges that I found with decorating this area, both this time and also previous times that I've done it, is just getting the colors right, because the stores themselves are so colorful. So even if I have like a set color palette for my island, I feel like I have to adjust it slightly to match the color palette of the two shops because they're so vibrant. So normally I would just go with like my green, blue, yellow color palette, and I definitely do use that color palette in this area, but I expanded it to oranges and reds and browns and other things just because of all of the primary colors going on. And I think it turned out really cute, but it was definitely, that was definitely a challenge when it came to working this build. Here I am placing down the bridge. I actually used to have a bridge here in this exact spot, and then I demolished it, and then I built this one, and hopefully I don't end up demolishing it again. I think it'll stay, but it just depends on how much space I need on the other side. And, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I can just, I'll find a way to make more money. I still have not figured out Treasure Islands. I am old and dumb and don't understand them, and I'm too nervous to ask for help. But I'll figure it out. I have to figure it out to finish this other build that I'm working on, because I can't keep ordering wheat fields. My game is in May right now because I keep setting my clock back so I can order more wheat fields. I'm not even in July. I'm 2 months behind. Can you believe that? Actually, no, lots of people are in different months than normal, but I don't want to be in May. I'm not in May because I love being in May. I'm in May because I'm trapped here. Help, please. Someone come get me. Let me know in the comments down below if you play seasonally, or if you just pick a season and you stay in it. I'm very curious. Or also, if, I guess it depends on your gameplay style, because I know a lot of people love to reset really often, and I admire that a lot, because it's like, you know, you have no attachments. You're like, if this island is not inspiring me, it's not bringing me joy, I'll just get rid of it. It'll be gone. You'll never see her again. Do you play like that? Do you reset often? Do you have the same island you've had since you got the game? How long have you had the game? Do you play it, like I said, seasonally, or do you... Ooh, there's another butterfly. Do you try to complete your museum? I'm very curious how different people approach the game, as it were. As you can see, I have taken a trip to Harv's Island. I have adjusted some things. I changed the colors on the truck. I added that cute little logo, the veggie logo. I changed the bike. I changed the ABD machine. I think I changed it again, maybe. I think I changed it to red. I tried to add these shopping baskets, and that is probably the thing that I am most likely to get rid of, just because it's just too many colors. And I ended up putting something else outside of Able Sisters. I don't know how this build is going to end up in the long term, but in the short term, I keep saying like, oh, I would change this, oh, I change that. I really like how this build turned out. Don't get it twisted, okay? This build is cute. I think my favorite part is probably the back of the shops, or maybe on the right side of Able Sisters with the clothesline pole and the fishing area. I put a fishing area. I don't remember if I mentioned that earlier in the video, but I put a fishing area because of course I did. Also, I got these little tables out that I didn't know I already had in my storage, so I ordered a couple more, and now I'm mad at myself that I did that, but it doesn't matter. It's fine. But I had the tables, and that I also think is really cute. I put some veggies and some jam on the Nook one, and then I put some clothes and shoes on the Able Sisters one, and I think it turned out really cute. How many times have I said that in this video? But you know what? It's true. I think it looks cute. But yeah, this is really actually starting to come together now. The rest of the build is a lot of adjusting. Me changing little things and changing the colors of things and running back and forth, like I said, to Hearth's Island and to my storage to grab new things to decorate with. Even though this was just a build where I was just moving two buildings and putting down some road codes and some objects, I think the total time that it took me to record and finish it was maybe like 6 or 7 hours. I'm really, really slow when it comes to details. My last video was an anomaly because even though it only took me maybe an hour or 2 hours to fully record the video, I did the entire thing off camera first and then recreated it on camera. So in actuality, I spent an entire day just on my couch playing the game and adjusting things and getting things how I wanted them. And then I came back and recorded it. But I wasn't able to do that with this video because I had to move the building. So I just sat down and I did it. And it, like I said, I like how it turned out, but it just took me forever because I'm very slow. But I do like how it turned out. That is one thing that I wouldn't say it holds me back necessarily, but it definitely is a hindrance, especially with stuff like The Sims, for example. It takes me forever to do a Sims house, like hours and hours and hours, even the smallest house, because my too much gene, I just keep touching things and changing things. I wish I could put stuff on top of the ABD. That would be helpful. I feel like the heights in that area were like a little bit weird, but you know, it's neither here nor there, that doesn't matter. Like I said, I am a very slow builder, so please forgive me if I ever, you know, it takes me a long time to do stuff. The other day, I was playing The Sims for fun, not just to, like, not to make a video. Not that the making the videos isn't fun, but, like, just, like, outside of work. I was making a cat cafe because I saw Lil Simsy make a cat cafe, and I wanted to make a cat cafe, and I downloaded, Hey Harry's CC set that's, like, for cafes and, like, restaurants and stuff. I forget what it's called. I think it's called Spoons? Maybe? I downloaded that CC set, and I was using it to make a cat cafe, and a little bit in it, like maybe 4 or 5 hours in, I had saved maybe like half an hour to an hour prior, but then my power went out for a couple seconds, and the build, I don't know, I just didn't touch it. I just gave up. I was like, you know what? That was a sign. I hadn't saved for, like I said, for at least half an hour. And that was a sign that I needed to stop, and I stopped, and I haven't touched it since. So I don't know what's going on with that cat cafe. It was cute. I can probably make it cute again. That's another thing too, is like, you know, sometimes a reset is a good thing. You know, sometimes you need to reset what you're doing and try again, and sometimes your electronics quit out on you and force you to do that against your will. But like I said, I haven't touched it since. So, you know, maybe one day I'll finish that and I'll play in it, but who knows. Ooh, speaking of The Sims 4, I promise I'll stop talking about The Sims in a minute. I know this is an Animal Crossing video, but speaking of The Sims 4, the high school pack looks like a lot of fun. I am so excited to get my hands on it, to get my hands on the build objects. I really want to send me and Chatter's future child to high school in the Let's Play when that gets started up again very soon. I know I keep promising it. I'm sorry that it keeps getting pushed back, but things keep happening to me. We've established this already, but let me know in the comments if you're excited for the high school pack, if you're gonna get it. Because I know I am. I need it in my life. That looks like a lot of fun. I want to make a boba shop. I love a little boba. You guys know that about me. Ooh, here I am messing with the bricks again. Okay, listen, let's talk about the bricks for a second, because I mentioned this earlier. I really like this brick code. It's 5 slots, which I love. I love a code that doesn't take up too many slots. I love how flexible it is, how I can make like a curvy twisty path as opposed to like the super straight rigid paths of the street code. And it's great for like alleyways and stuff. I found this other code that's 4 tiles as opposed to 5, and it has that sort of same vibe to it. It's like a light gray tile path, and so obviously the light gray would match really well with all of the gray roads and the white fences on my island. But I like the brick because of like it feels like New England-y. Like brick is very New England-y. You know, there's lots of brick streets and brick alleyways and brick walls and things. And so I'm just torn. You know, I'm torn, besties. Let me know in the comments what you think. I'm sorry I keep asking you opinions, but I need a second opinion on this because I just don't know. But I don't hate the brick. I don't know. Maybe I'll change the color. There's a ton of colors that this code comes in, so maybe I'll change the color. Oh yeah, here I am working in the fishing area. I had to put a fishing area, okay? Well, my villagers love to fish in this spot, so I just thought it was perfect, and I love to fish in this spot. I mean, it's a good spot to fish. There's lots of, you know, they've got the river and everything. A good spot for catching expensive river fish when it's in season, which it's not for me because I'm stuck in May, as we've established, unfortunately. I was also messing with this area a little bit, adding some more trash. Gotta have the trash, besties. Don't litter, though, in real life. Only in Animal Crossing. Don't litter in real life. Only Animal Crossing litter is allowed. I think I moved that lamp to the other side. I also put that sock on the ground because I thought it was cute and it matches the blue colors going on back there. This is the area where the blue and the yellow and the green really popped off. That's my classic color scheme. And she returned with a vengeance in this area of the build. I don't know why, but she just came about. Maybe it's that chair. Maybe it's the folding chair and then the skateboard. I don't remember what color I ended up going with for the skateboard. I experimented with a ton of them, but I either went with the yellow or like the busted skateboard. I don't remember. Like I said earlier, I'm kind of envisioning this as like a pedestrian area. So there's lots of bikes, so the skateboard on the ground, but there's no cars. That might be something that changes. I don't know. There's a ton of cars elsewhere on my island, especially by the beach. And of course there's that truck, but I imagine that truck sort of came in via the bridge. So that's sort of, I don't know, my vision in my mind of like the logistics of the build. I don't know, it doesn't have to like actually make sense because it's just Animal Crossing, but I wanted to have some sort of realism to it because it is sort of, it's a town core build, you know, it's like a real town. Oh yeah, Kiki came up with a new nickname for me. It's Pumpkin, a classic villager nickname. It used to be Bestie, so that's a little unfortunate that we got rid of Bestie, but Pumpkin is cute. Oh yeah, I put a bike here and I caught another Agrius butterfly because I'm just a pro bug catching monster. Earlier in the week, as I was playing this, Flick was here and I sold a bunch of bugs to him and I made an okay amount of money. Not a crazy amount, but I made a pretty good amount. I made a couple hundred thousand off of some bugs that I just had in my storage over time. That's honestly one of my best money-making tips in this game. If you don't like to play online, if you don't like the stock market, just like catching bugs and fish and then waiting for Flick and CJ to come and selling them to them, like over time, and like keeping a ton of them in your storage so that you're like ready to sell when they come to visit you. That's one of my best tips. Every time you catch a rare bug or fish, just put it in your storage, wait for them to come, sell it, make some money, and save it. I don't know. That always helps me if I'm low on cash. That like, especially if I need to like build a bridge or an incline or something, if I just sell a bunch of bugs and then I'll just have 100,000 in my pocket and I can just pay for it like outright. It's nice. But that's also because I love catching fish and bugs. I know not everyone loves to do that in this game. That's totally valid. There's tons of ways to play Animal Crossing. That's what's so fun about it. This is we're sort of coming to, not the end of the build. We're kind of close to the end. We're a little bit close to the end. The area outside of Able Sisters, as you can see, is like a two-tiered area. I might change that because like I said, it is in the street. Oh, Bo crossed the street. Did he use the light? I worry about that boy sometimes. He has this helmet that I gave him. It's a bike helmet and it's orange, so it like matches his fur. It's really, really cute. I gave it to him a long time ago back when like people didn't know how to get villager photos. So that was, I was just like giving them clothes that were colors that they liked. And Bo really likes like brown and orange and stuff. So I was giving him orange clothes and I gave him that that bike helmet and he wears it all the time. And it's so cute because it's like, he really does need a bike helmet. Like he needs to be safe. I worry about him. He's very dumb. I worry about that boy a lot. But, you know, he's my best friend, as we've established. He used to not be my best friend. If you've been here for a minute, you know, Bo and I used to be feuding. But now he's my bestie, so that's good. There hasn't really been much drama. Actually, the other day, when I was working on the beach area, Coco was, oh look, they're doing the zoomies, that was so cute. Coco was staking out Marshall and Genji's houses. She would like hang out outside of Marshall's house and then she would move and then hang out outside of Genji's house, and it was very sus. And she was like trying to act non-suspicious, like she would like sit and read her little book and then when I walked over she would get up and like walk away. It's like, Coco, I see you, bestie, I see what you're doing. So I don't know what's up with her, but I don't wanna, that's too much for, I was in the ER. I don't need to be dealing with all of this. No offense to you, Coco. Maddie, that was a little bit annoying of you, not gonna lie. When you zoomed right in there and I was trying to place down this leaf pile, I was just trying to fill up the space a little bit because, I don't know, it was just like, it's just a road. So I'm like, this feels like it's empty, but it's not empty. It's just that I feel like it's empty, even though it's not. Does that make sense? I don't know, besties. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. It's that portion of the build. We're 35 minutes in. I've been doing a lot. Caught a lot of bugs, popped a lot of balloons, been to Harv's Island a couple dozen times, it feels like. I changed the ABD to the red color. I don't know if I like it or not, but I changed it, and it's there, so I hope you enjoy that. Other than that, though, it's mostly just me adjusting little tiny things, moving them here and there. This is why it takes me so long to do stuff. How long does it take you to build things? In The Sims, in Animal Crossing? I know I keep asking you guys questions, but I'm, like, curious. Like, how long does it take you to build stuff? Because, once again, speaking of Lil Simsy, I've been watching her videos for a long time. Like back before she was Lil Simsy, her first channel. I was watching that channel, and I remember when it got stolen by her neighbor, and then she had to make the Lil Simsy channel. But anyway, she's been doing daily uploads for years. And part of the reason she's able to do that is because she can make a really beautiful build in, like, 1 to 2 hours, and sometimes even like less than that, like 30 to 45 minutes. And I am very jealous because it takes me at least like 6 hours to build a one bedroom house. I don't know why. I don't know what it is about me. Once again, probably the too much gene, not gonna lie. Speaking of too much gene, here I am changing an area and then changing it right back because I have absolutely no chill, just like Bob, who was zooming around. But yeah, we're almost at the end. Look at that. Like I said, I have one more question for you. I'll save it for the end. It has to do with live streaming, because I haven't streamed in a minute because of the combination of the bug incident and the hospital incident together sort of limited my streaming capacity. But I want to stream again soon. I'm just going to ask it now. What do you guys want me to stream tomorrow? I'm going to stream tomorrow, Monday, July 18th, if you're watching this the day that it goes live. If it's Monday, July 18th, when you are watching this in the future, hello future people, it's nice to see you. Let me know what you want me to stream. I want to do City Folk again, but I might do a combo stream of City Folk and something else. I still have not found my memory card, so sorry, apologies for that. I really want to play Harvest Moon, but I cannot find my memory card. We might play My Sims Kingdom, maybe we'll play some more Kirby, I don't know, whatever you guys are down for, I'm down for. So let me know in the comments one more time what you guys want to see. The last thing I added, I think, was the sandwich board. I don't know why, I just feel like the color of it looked nice, and that was why I added it. So there it goes, and I changed this one more time because I cannot pick what I want to do. But yeah, I think, oh yeah, I added a little light on the other side of the bridge because I thought it looked nice, and I'll work on this area next. We'll see this area very soon, besties, so get excited for that. But here we are at the end of the build. All right, besties, that is going to be it for me. Thank you all so, so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this extra long video today. I really like how this build turned out. I think it turned out really cute. If you like how it turned out, you can leave a like to let me know, or leave a comment. Both of those really help out the channel. If you really, really liked it, you can subscribe and hit the little bell to be notified every time that I post or go live. You can also join my Discord, linked in the description, or follow me on Instagram, where I also post notifications when I post or go live. I post Animal Crossing videos here twice a week on Wednesdays and Saturdays, normally when I don't go to the hospital, which is most weeks. I try to go live over here on YouTube at least once a week, and like I said, I'm going live tomorrow playing City Folk, so swing by and come hang out. It'll be fun, and we'll probably play something else too, maybe My Sims Kingdom, who knows. But yeah, anyways, thank you all again for watching, and if I don't see you on Monday, then I hope to see you all again on Wednesday. Bye!